Welcome back to biology class. We are discussing classification of animals. We have learnt that animals without backbone are known as invertebrates, and invertebrates are further grouped into 8 different classes. These are class Porifera, class Cnidaria, class Platyhelminths, class Annelida, class Nematoda, class Mollusca, class Echinodermata, and class Arthropoda. In our last class, we discussed the characteristics and examples of class Porifera and class Cnidaria. Today, we will discuss class Platyhelminths, which consist of flatworms, and class Nematoda, which consist of roundworms. First of all, class Platyhelminths. Class Platyhelminths consist of worms, which are also known as flatworms. The main characteristics of Platyhelminths or flatworms are: their body is thin and flat. They mostly live as parasites in the bodies of other animals called hosts. Children, parasite is an organism that lives on or in other living organism and gets its nutrition from it. Around their mouth, they have structures called hooks and suckers. Hooks and suckers present around their mouth allow them to securely attach to their host. We can also find them in fresh water and a moist environment. Common examples of flatworms are liver fluke and tapeworm. Let us know more about flatworms.
They're both terrestrially and in the water, and basically everywhere on Earth, even Antarctica. They can come in a variety of colors, and some will even appear translucent. Their size range also varies pretty drastically between the species. On average, one could say that they are typically less than an inch in length, but really, they can reach up to 50 feet. I mean, you've probably heard some tapeworm horror stories. They also typically only have one opening in their body that serves multiple purposes, meaning they use the same hole as both a means for taking in food and for excreting it after it has been digested. Here's to hoping they don't have taste buds. The free-living flatworms are mostly carnivorous and will eat something as small as a single-celled organism, like a protozoan, to something much larger than them, like crabs and mollusks. The parasitic ones will feed off their hosts in many different ways. It really just depends on the relationship.
Class Nematoda. Class Nematoda consists of roundworms. The main characteristics of Nematoda or roundworms are: their body is rounded and unsegmented, that is, body is not divided into segments. Most of them live as parasites in the bodies of other animals, including humans. Ascaris is a roundworm that lives in the small intestine of humans, commonly in children who eat with unwashed hands. So children, one of the best ways to prevent health problems from germs and worms is to wash hands with soap and water on a regular basis. Common examples of roundworms are Ascaris and hookworm. Let us learn more about nematodes.
Nematodes, or roundworms, are traditionally regarded as the phylum Nematoda. Nematodes are considered one of the most diverse of all animal phyla. The nematode species can be difficult to distinguish, and over 25,000 different species have been discovered. By some estimates, there's still about 1 million that are yet to be found. Out of the 25,000 species that have been discovered, well over half are parasitic. Nematodes are considered to be some of the most ubiquitous animals. Roundworms can be found in most aquatic habitats, in the soil, in the tissues of a lot of plants, and also in the body fluids and tissues of most animals. The cylindrical bodies of a nematode can range from less than 1 millimeter to more than 1 meter in length. The body of a nematode, which is long and narrow, often resembles a tiny piece of string. The word nematode actually comes from a Greek word, nema, which means thread.
Today we learned the main characteristics and examples of class Platyhelminths and Nematoda. Children, flatworms and roundworms do not have any organs for movement. Then how do they move? Think about it. We will discuss this in our interactive session. Till then, stay safe. Thank you.